Thanks. So I changed books, and I changed songs. And so I'm gonna sing a little bit of a different song, I'm gonna do a little different book. And next year, about a year from now, I'm gonna sing you a different song, which I already know what it is, and I'm gonna read a different book to you. So I don't wanna read you the same book twice. A lot of looping has to do with that. I don't wanna do the same stuff with you. We're gonna do new things and learn new things. Well, this book is called Forever Young, and it's the song written by Bob Dylan. And his real name is Robert Zimmerman. And he's from Hibbing, Minnesota, an Iron Range town up north of Minnesota. And what's interesting about this book, it's kind of a biography. And it's a biography through pictures. The words to the book are actually lyrics to the song Forever Young. But the pictures in the book tell Bob Dylan's experience of going to New York City. Now, not everybody likes Bob Dylan singing. In fact, he's got kind of a gravelly voice. He kind of sings like, that's how he sings. Now, people really like him and people really don't. And he lived a really interesting life. He has. He's an older guy now and he's still touring like crazy and he still does all, he plays his music. But when he was a kid, he found out that Woody Guthrie, remember that song we saw the other day with Woody Guthrie in it? This Land Is Your Land, that book that we watched. Woody Guthrie was dying in New York. Bob Dylan found out, and he was an influence of Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan left home. He kind of ran away. He ran to New York City because he wanted to see Woody Guthrie before he died. So he went to Woody's hospital room, and he actually played a few songs for Woody. Thank you. That's very nice. He actually played a few songs for Woody in his hospital room. Well, Bob Dylan went to New York, and he said, you know what? I'm going to make a name for myself. I'm going to make it in the music industry. And so we started playing clubs in New York City. And people said, you're never going to make it. In fact, people even said, and there have been all kinds of books written on him. All kinds of books, movies made about him, all sorts of things. And I've read a couple of biographies, and people said, forget it, man. You're from a small town in Minnesota, and you think you're going to come out of the New York music scene and make it? There's no way. Bob Dylan never doubted it. They interviewed him to this day. I said, I never doubted that I'd make it. I have no doubts in my life. I went out there, I had a dream, and I was going to do it. You guys, there's a lesson in that for you. There's a real lesson there. There is something inside every one of you. There's a gift, a real gift, inside every single person in this room. And if you follow it, and if you believe in it, and if you go with it, amazing things are going to happen. And you are going to do amazing things. Now what happens, though, this is a tricky deal, there's all kinds of distractions along the way. Bob Dylan didn't get distracted. He knew what he wanted to do, he went after it, and he never gave up, and all of a sudden he got discovered and he got a record contract with CBS Records and he became the biggest thing. Yeah. Now Bob Dylan also did something. He came on the scene at a time where music was really changing, and people saw him as tumultuous, you guys. He was a tumultuous figure. In fact, people couldn't figure him out. He came on the folk scene, which was all acoustic guitars, like I'm going to play for you in a second. And everyone loved him in the folk music scene. And all of a sudden, you know what he did at the folk music festival? He came up with his band. You know what they plugged in? Electric guitars. And people went bananas. He had broken a sacred rule to music, and people were so mad at him. His own bands, they tried to boo him off the stage. Bob Dylan still stuck with his guns and said, you know what? I don't care. This is what I do, and this is what I am. And if you don't like it, I'll throw away my whole career doing it, because this is what I'm about. He never flinched, you guys. He never, ever flinched. He was always like, well, this is what it is. Take it or leave it. You can boo at me. I don't really care. He didn't even say that to the audience. I don't know what your problem is. Pete Seeger, even this musician, was so mad. He had a big axe in his hands at this festival, and he was going to cut all the electrical wires with it. And they had to stop him from doing it. He was so incensed that Bob Dylan would do this. Bob Dylan just kept on doing it. He kept on doing it. And then Bob Dylan asked a question. You know what this question was in the song that he pulled out the electric guitars for the first time he did it? How does it feel? He kept asking that through the whole song. And the song is called Like a Rolling Stone. It became a bestseller. People went wild for it. People either hated it or they loved it. But it asked, how does it feel? And I ask you today, how does it feel? How does it feel? Now, you might not think much about that right now. You're going from second grade to third grade. But I'm telling you something right now. You guys, it goes fast. This all happens real quick. Next year, a year from now, we'll be sitting here doing kind of the same thing. It's going to go really, really fast. And we'll be back here. And I will ask you again, how does it feel? How does it feel to be confident? How does it feel to know who you are and be? I've watched you grow this year. What it should feel like is pride. What it should feel like is confidence. That's what it should feel like. So I ask you, how does it feel? And I want you to think about that question, because that's what Dylan was asking. How does it feel? And where are you going, and what are you going to be? And he's someone that keeps asking questions. Now, this book is called Forever Young. This is not like a Rolling Stone, but the lyrics to it. And what's interesting about this book, and I got it, this is Bob Dylan right there, and it says, dig yourself. Which means, it's Bob Dylan's way of saying, believe in yourself. That's really it. It's what he's saying. Dig yourself. Believe in yourself. And there he is standing with this sign. And there's a famous music video where he tosses these signs off to the side while the lyrics go by. It's a famous clip of him. Now, if you look at this, every illustration in the back of the book explains the significance. There's something in every one of these pictures that talks about him and his experience of leaving Minnesota, just north of here, and going out and following his dream. And the first line is, may God bless you and keep you always. And in every one of these pages, there's something there. It's a biography written in pictures. It's really quite cool. May God bless you and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. There's a little kid playing guitar in the living room. Yeah, you gotta, but even, you know what's great about this book? There's a Woody Guthrie album sitting by the stereo. And there's a kid playing his guitar next to this Woody Guthrie album. So every picture has some kind of influence. May you always do for others and let others do for you. And these people that are standing in the audience, every one of them has a significance in that era of music. If you go to the back, it'll say who that person is, and who that person is. And I think Pete Seeger is actually even on this page. I think he's one of the characters on that page, the guy who tried to cut his electrical cords so he couldn't play. May you build a ladder into the stars and climb on every rung. And this is Greenwich Village, New York. That's where Bob Dylan went, and he kind of went from couch to couch. And these are all the places that he played, and there's someone up in an apartment. I think that's Bob Dylan practicing his songs before he goes down to these clubs and kind of tries to make it big. May you stay forever young, forever young, forever young. May you stay forever young. And there he is looking up into the stars and seeing constellations of the things that he's dreaming about in his dream. And he was quite a dreamer. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. And again, here's an Elvis Presley and a Johnny Cash, and all the different influences to Bob Dylan are in there. People that we know about, people that we learned about this year. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong. And may you stay forever young. It's a bass. It's playing a little band there. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. Highway 61. He lived up Highway 61. And he wrote a song about it. May you have a strong foundation for when the winds of changes shift, which means things are going to change, you guys. And especially as you grow up, things really change. And different things are going to come along. You got to be strong in who you are. You got to know who you are. Because when you face these things, you got to be able to say, you know what, that's not for me, or that's all right. And again, all these people, they're significant people in the history of it. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. I bet you guys know the next song. What is it? May you stay forever young. Forever young. How many of you guys have heard the song? How many roads must a man walk before he comes in? That's him. That's him.
You can barely hear him.
Forever young. He's passing it on to a child, saying, this is your time. How does it feel? Are you ready for this?
Answer me.
Alright, so on all those pages, and I want to sing you a little song, and you might recognize some of the words, but I'm going to put the words down here. I did not memorize them. Now, I don't know if I should do this in a Dylan twang or just my voice.
Dylan twang.
No, no, I can't. May God bless you and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder unto the stars and climb on every rung. Oh, sorry, climb on every rung. And may you stay forever young. May you stay forever young. Oh, here's the part that I wrote for you guys. May you always remember that you are BBA. May you always be a friend that shows others the way. May you always do your best, no matter what the test. May you stay forever. May you come back to visit your teacher every so often. May you see him at the store, maybe out of shopping. May you continue to play with him when the year is done.
Congratulations,
everyone.
Let's hear it for the graduating.